Roger helped everyone in his life, and he never spoke of it. He gave his time and his money and his influence, and he gave his heart. Then last year, we began to learn of another side of Roger Ailes, another part of his life. I didn't believe it could be true at first. This man I so admired, despite our differences. It all came to a head as hundreds of us were in Cleveland for the Republican convention. The accusations were mortifying. All cameras were trained on us, all of them. We were the news. Tears flowed daily off camera, so far from headquarters, confused and helpless, unnerved and under attack. Roger would want us to perform, to serve our audience, and we did, somehow. In our private workspace there, by then surrounded by guards keeping prying reporters away from us, a cell phone was being passed around. Roger was on the line. I took it in my hand and said, "Roger? Hey, how you doing?" His voice was firm and reassuring. "I'm okay, Roger. We're all working hard." There was a private exchange then, and he told me, "Keep up the good work. Keep everybody motivated and on point. We'll get through this. I love you." That was the last we spoke. He left the company, and the rest is history unfolding. To the true victims, respect and comfort. It's all so complicated. Everything here was and is as he was.